Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Warm welcome in the EMO Speakers Corner. And thanks a lot for taking your time and attending the DWS presentation about our future mobility maker. After seeing this little trailer, I'm quite convinced that you are very interested in our future mobility makers. So let's get started with the presentation. First of all, I would like to give you a quick overview about the DWS Technology Group. Our group consists of three business units. The first business unit, Machine Tools and Automation, which generates about 60% of our revenue. In this business unit, you will recognize some very famous names such as Buderus, Pittler and Prevema. The second business unit, Tools and Components, contributes about 20% of our revenues. In order to provide the whole manufacturing solution, we internally develop and manufacture grinding wheels, honing wheels and dressers. The last business unit is the DWS Production, which contributes to the last 20% of our revenues. The DWS Production manufactures key components for electric drives. We deliver components such as ring gears, pinions and rotor shafts to the big players in the automotive industry, for example Volkswagen, ZF and GKN. By producing such components on our DWS machine tools in serious production, we are in the unique position to feedback this production knowledge into our machine and process design. In the next section, I like to talk a little bit about different gearboxes and tools workpieces in electric vehicles. Compared with the powertrain for combustion engines, electric vehicles do have some special requirements, mainly due to two key facts of their electric drives. First, typical electric motors in electric vehicles rotate up to 30,000 RPMs. Second, the noise, vibration and harshness behavior is of significant relevance. In consequence, the geared components in the e-axle do have following requirements. First, gear qualities 4 to 5 are needed. Very low surface waviveness is required, a tendency to finest surfaces like RZ below 1. And last but not least, narrow shape and position tolerances to prevent unbalance. On this picture, you see a typical offset drive of an e-axle for electric vehicles. It mainly consists of three key components: the step pinion, the ring gear and the rotor shaft, which we call e-shaft. On this slide, you see the second typical configuration of a gearbox for electric vehicles, the concentric drive. In contrast to the offset drive, it has a planetary gear set. The DVS group can provide manufacturing solutions, for example, for the pinion, the step planetary gear, and the ring gear. Let's have a look on the eShaft now. In general, there are two versions of eShafts. On this slide, it was too fast. On this slide, you see the first configuration, first version of eShafts. This one is a splined version. The rotor shaft has a spline. The running gear is realized by a gear pinion, which is applied to the rotor shaft. The second version, this is the second version, so the running gear is already machined on the eShaft. It's usually a hollow shaft, and this design does have three advantages. It does have higher accuracy of the gearing to the bearing seats. It does have lower rotating masses, so lower inertias. And of course, the good news is it does have lower costs because just one gear cutting process instead of three gear cutting operations. So that's the biggest advantage. Let's have a closer look on an efficient e-production now. The following flow chart is showing the DVS solution for an integrated eShaft production. On the first machine, the complete soft machining is done. This includes turning, drilling, milling, and power skiving. As the next step, the workpiece will be hardened. After the heat treatment, the complete hard fine machining is done. As the last step, the running gear will be honed. And finally, there is the washing operation. So with this solution, an eShaft can be produced on three cutting machine tools only, from the raw material to the ready-made eShaft. So let me quickly introduce our machines, the future mobility maker for this process. First, we have the WMZ V300, a horizontal turning machine, our all-rounder for geared shafts. Second, the Buderus UFlex and 235, our horizontal hard-fining machining centers for superior quality. And last but not least, the Prevema Synchrofine, our power honing all-star. The WMZ V300 is capable of doing the complete soft machining. Typical operations on an eShaft, including turning of the outer diameters, milling of key surfaces, deep hole drilling, and the gear power skiving. On this slide, you see a typical configuration of a V300 for complete machining, consisting of two main spindles, a multifunction turret and a turret. A typical cycle time for an eShaft on this machine would be around 4.5 minutes. On the UFlex or 235, all hard fine machining operations can be done, such as grinding of critical outer diameters for the bearing seats, the rotor seat, seal surfaces, as well as hard turning of face surfaces. This is our Buderus UFlex, an ideal machine for ramp-up purposes. It's a very flexible machine which can work on the eShaft in sequential processes, as you can see on those pictures. As a first step, it machines the right shaft end, then the left one, and then the rotor seat. Die 235 Series is the one for serious production, as it allows simultaneous machining thanks to its two multifunction turrets with four grinding wheels. The concept is very flexible and productive at the same time. Typical cycle times for an E-shaft are around 2 minutes. Last but not least, in order to achieve the desired noise vibration harshness properties of an E-shaft, the running gear needs to be honed on our Prevema Synchrofine. And the Prevema Synchrofine is equipped with DVS tooling, a honing wheel and a Vario speed tracer. Thanks to this unique combination, we are in a position to achieve RZ values below 1 micrometer. Okay, after this introduction of the DVS eShaft solution, let me summarize the benefits. First, thanks to the complete machining process, we have fewer clamping operations and therefore higher accuracies. There are lower unit costs due to fewer machines and less personnel required, lower maintenance costs, less space and less energy costs. Last but not least, thanks to the highly integrated machine concepts, the production line can be adapted to other E-shafts, which means high flexibility. According to our calculations, the introduced process can save up to 30 to 40% costs compared to conventional processes. So that's a pretty nice result. Okay, so that's from my side. It was a very quick introduction of the DVS group and our E-shaft solution for an efficient manufacturing process for rotor shafts, E-shafts for electric vehicles. So if you'd like to know more details, of course, you are very welcome to see us in our booth. We are in Hall 2, booth F23.